Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys doing? Thank you for tuning in, thank you for coming back, thank you for stopping by. In case you're new here, in case you've seen this face for the first time, you're welcome. Nice to meet you. My name is Teresa and I'm a Nigerian YouTuber living in France, Lyon to be precise. So guys, today I'm going to be doing my first ever story time. Yes, I don't think I've done a story time here before, maybe just a little bit here and there, but like a sit-down story time, this is going to be my first ever story time. So guys, I suck at telling stories, so bear with me. Just bear with me. So why I'm making this video today is because Google sent me a reminder. Yes, they sent me a reminder, like a picture of my daughter I took when she was a year and a half, because she suffered a burn, like she got burned. I don't even know the right word to use, like she burned herself with hot water. Yeah. It all started one Sunday, yes. So that Sunday, we are supposed to like go to church. Then my daughter was be like a year and 5 months, yeah, thereabout. So we were supposed to go to church that Sunday morning, but I just had work to do. I decided not to go to church because then I prefer to like wash her clothes with my hands. I just felt like there was no need washing it in the washing machine. I don't know, maybe it was just in my head, like a new mom, you know, want to do the most and all that. So I had a lot of clothes to wash and I decided not to go to church. On Saturday, I like to like plan my Sundays if I want to go to church, but because if I don't, it's always hard to like go to church not knowing what you're going to eat when you get back and all that. And that day was like that, so it was hard for me to like go to church, which I regretted. Yes, I regretted it. So guys, after washing Amoni's clothes, like after washing her clothes, I went to the kitchen to like make food for her. Then she was no longer a little baby, but she was still eating, yeah, puree here and there, Quaker oats and Cerelac, you know, all those food that baby eat. So that fateful day, she was hungry. It was like 12 o'clock, yeah, 12 p.m. and she was hungry. So I was already done doing the laundry, yeah, so I went to the kitchen to like make food for her and at the same time make lunch for us to eat, like when Obi get back from church he will have something to eat. So while I was in the kitchen, I think I have a kettle then, but I don't know why I did not use the kettle and decided to like warm up the water in the microwave. So like I pour some water into a bowl, I put it in the microwave. When the water is hot, then I just add the Cerelac and make it. So that's how I normally do it. But on this fateful day, I don't know what happened, I was in the kitchen and Amoni was also there with me. She was, I don't know if she, because she was really hungry or I don't know, I don't just know how to explain it. If maybe it's just something that wants to happen, you know, when something wants to happen, no matter how careful you are, it will still happen. So the water was in the microwave and I was close to the gas, which is a little bit far from the microwave. I was making food. So before I knew it, and the water was already boiling. So when the water boiled, the microwave kind of stopped working. And when she heard that noise, you know that noise that the microwave stopped, before I knew it, my daughter just opened the microwave and brought out the hot water. Everything just happened in a rush. I was in the kitchen with her. I don't know, if you ask me now, I will not even know how to explain that to you guys. Before I know it, she already opened the microwave and she dragged out the water. And while she was just bringing out the water, that's how the thing just... the thing just poured on her face, like on her face, on her body, like... Before I ran from where I was cooking to like where the microwave is, this thing have already happened. Like everything just happened in a rush. I was so confused. I didn't know what to do. I had to rush her to the bathroom and started pouring water on her. I think normally this is something that you're not supposed to do when somebody get burnt or something, but I don't know. I was confused. I have to like just pour cold water on her. I have to call the emergency, like we call them pompier over here. I have to call them that my daughter got burned. She poured hot water on herself and that was it. So I also called her hubby at church and I told him everything that had happened. So that was how the firemen came and they wrapped her up in one plastic stuff like that and we got to the hospital. Like it was an emergency, like they quickly cleaned her up, gave her something like to calm the pain down because she was in pain. She was really really in pain and guys, it did not end there. You know, as a parent, you know that feeling when you see your little one just go through love. Man, she needed to see her face. You needed to see her arm. Oh my gosh. Like anytime I just looked at it, I was just crying. I was in tears. I was just shedding tears. Like, and the worst part of it was that I was feeling guilty. It was as if I was the one that took hot water and poured on her. That was just how I was feeling. I was like, why didn't I go to church? If I went to church, this would not have happened. A lot of things start to run in your head. You start to question yourself. You even start to question God, like, God, why? I was at that stage in my life. I just felt guilty. And my hubby, at the other hand, just made everything worse by it. He also kind of blamed me for it, like, if I had gone to church, like if we had all gone to church, this wouldn't have happened, you know? It's like you're blaming yourself and there is someone else blaming you. You know, everything just add up. And before you know it, guys, that period, that time, I was like, not far from being miserable. I won't lie to you guys. Okay, let me continue from the hospital. After everything, Obi brought a church member of hers and they came. Then we didn't have a car, so they came and they brought us home. And yeah, so after that was when the real problem started. Like anytime I see my daughter's face, I just start feeling guilty. I was just crying. I was just asking myself why I did not go to church. And I was also scared that she was going to like grow up and have scars all over and she was going to hate me for it. And anytime I just think of that, I would just start crying, like, oh God, this girl was not born like this. I did not give birth to my daughter with scars. How come hot water just splashed on her and now she's going to like grow up with scars all over her face and her arm, you know? I was just beating myself up. I couldn't help it. That was like the worst time of my life, as in the worst moment ever in my life. Like I felt so bad. I felt guilty. I felt like I failed as a mom. I felt like the worst mom ever on earth. I don't even know the right word to explain this. Sometimes I would just go to the park and just start crying. Like when I take my daughter to the park and I see her with the, anytime I just look at her face, I'm going to be inserting some pictures. And mind you, these pictures I'm going to be inserting, they are not like when the thing happened or maybe just few days after that, because then I was not even thinking of taking pictures. I was just miserable. Like, taking pictures was the last thing on my mind. So these pictures are maybe like few weeks later or stuff like that. The whole thing just happened as a miracle, that after few months and after few months later, and the whole thing just started. It started by peeling off. It became dry, because even after we got home from the hospital, we have to contact a nurse. So the nurse kind of come home like to take care of the face, clean it, and just add something. So that continued for a while. So before we know it, the thing kind of just dried up and started peeling off. Even when it peeled off, her face was very white. Normally Harmony is a light skinned baby. She was, even now she's getting darker. Like when she was born, she was like very white. Yeah, she was very white. Even people were asking me if her dad is a white guy or something. She was very white. So even when that place was peeling off, the thing became very white. Very, very white. I thought maybe the skin is going to like just remain like that, and it wasn't that. It wasn't looking very good. It was like she was having discoloration on her face. Everything was not the same color. I just felt that she was going to grow up looking like that, and one day she's going to ask questions. I'd be like, mommy, what happened to me? And I'm going to tell her the story, and she's going to feel like I failed her as a mom, I didn't really care for her and all that, which wasn't the story. So why I'm making this video is that we just have to be careful as a mom, as a parent. We have to be careful, and also if something happened to a child, we should stop blaming the mom for it. Yes, some kids' energy level are on the high side. Like, no matter how careful you are, there are still stuff that will happen. You will not, it will just happen like a film in your eyes, and you will not even know how to explain it. Yeah, so you have to stop blaming moms for things that happen to the kids, because I don't believe there is any mom that will just sit down, fold their hand and let things happen to their kids. Like, if I had known that was going to happen that day, I probably would not have even allowed her to be in the kitchen with me. Yes, I would maybe put Katu for her and ask her to stay in the living room or even in her room while I make her food. So I didn't even know that such things was going to happen. So I just give God the glory, I give God the adoration that it ended in praise, and today she don't even have any scar on her body. So when I see her, I just like, oh my God, this is a miracle, because God know how I cried. God knows, oh my God, English is hard. God knew how miserable I was when the thing happened. Like, God knew that if she had grew up with scars on her face, I was like going to beat myself up forever. God knew that. That was why everything just disappeared like a magic. Everything just disappeared. And looking at my daughter now without a scar on her face, I'm like, God, thank you for everything. Thank you for all you have done in my life. Thank you for all you have done in the life of my daughter. Thank you for all you have done in the life of my family. I can't just thank him enough. So guys, I don't want this video to be too long. Yeah, since Gogo decided to remind me of this, I just decided to like share it with you guys, and you guys can see our face. Yeah, there is nothing on our face anymore. Yeah, but there's a little bit of scar on our hands. So this is what it looked like. You cannot really tell. I think with time it's going to clear off and all that. So guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the story time, and I hope I was not all over the place. Like I said before, I suck at telling stories, so you gonna manage them like that. Manage it like that. Thank you for watching, and if this is your first time here, please do well by joining the family. Like, give me a thumbs up and press that red subscribe button. Join the family. So guys, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in my next one. Bye bye. Love you. Ciao ciao. Bye guys.